Hi, welcome to the Life You Always Wanted video 2. Let's recap. Why are you watching these videos and what happened to you when you gave your life to Jesus? You may ask that question, what exactly did happen to me when I opened my heart to Jesus and he came into my life? Well, the Bible says, number one, that you were saved from eternal damnation. You were separated from God, destined to live without him forever, but Jesus has saved your soul. Then you also got born again. The Holy Spirit came and lived on the inside of you now. Then on top of that, all of your sins were forgiven. How awesome is that? Past sins, present sins, future sins. Jesus took them all at the cross and paid a hefty price so that you can enjoy your new life. That's the next thing that happened to you. You received new life. And then on top of all of that, you also became a member of God's global family. So you see, getting saved, receiving Jesus in your heart was the best decision you've ever made. So praise God for that. Now let's move forward and talk about prayer as one of the primary exercises that you need to have in your new life as a believer. The Bible says that just as you accepted Christ as your Lord, you must continue to follow him, letting your roots grow deep into him and let your whole lives be built on him. Then, when you do those things, your faith will become strong in the truth you were taught and you will overflow with thanksgiving. So, what is God expecting of you now that you are saved? Well, he's expecting you to grow and to become like Jesus. That's his design for you. And prayer is the primary way to access that journey of a lifelong growing in God, learning how to pray. What is prayer, you may ask? Great question. To simplify it, it'll be easy for you to get this definition. Prayer is enjoying fellowship with God, or having communion with God, or being with God, conversing with him, speaking with him, and letting him speak into my life, listening to him and having him listening to me. That's what prayer really, it all boils down to. And the greatest model that we have of a person of prayer is none other than Jesus. Jesus, the Son of God, is the greatest example of a person of prayer. Jesus didn't pray just to give us a good example that we need to pray or we ought to pray. But Jesus prayed because he had to pray. It was this need as he lived this life on earth that he needed to be connected to his source in heaven with his heavenly Father. And so he gives us a lot of good clues on how to have a growing prayer life. For instance, we know that he prayed early in the morning. Your mind will be more open in the morning, so get used to communicating with God early in the morning. The Bible tells us that Jesus prayed often. The Bible tells us that Jesus prayed alone. So early in the morning, doing it repeatedly, daily, and praying alone will definitely guarantee that you will grow in your prayer life. So here's a guide to help you pray in this journey you have with Jesus. Think of the word pray, P-R-A-Y, and each of those letters will have an acrostic that's gonna help you to better pray. For instance, the letter P, you could use it for praise. In other words, when you begin conversing or talking with God, give time to praise him. Begin praising him. You know, praising is when I can acknowledge another person's attributes. So acknowledge all that God has done for you, who he is, and this will open the pathway for you to better pray. Number two, R for and pray, and the word pray is repent. In other words, ask for forgiveness if you have missed the mark, and you will, but there'll be grace from the Lord to give it to you then. So apply that grace into your life. A means ask. What are you needing God to do in your life? He already knows it, but he wants to hear it from you. So ask him, what is it that you're asking? And finally, the Y is for yield. This is when I yield my will to the Father and let him do his work in my heart. So go ahead and begin your prayer life. Go ahead and begin to grow in your journey with Jesus. Remember, nothing can replace your prayer life, and then nothing can compensate for not praying. So God is expecting you to hang out with him. Why don't you go ahead and begin now. Spend some time alone with the Father. Communicate with him, and you'll see that as you do it, he's going to help you to continue growing in your prayer life. All right, catch you next time for exercise number three, the exercise of the word. Catch you then.